Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October the 18th of 2020, well, it is titled UGC 1810 Wildly Interacting Galaxy from Hubble. So what do we see here? Well, this is an example of a spiral galaxy, and we can see the distinct spiral arms swirling out from the interior. And we can see the outer ring of the galaxy as very prominently blue. Now, the blue coloring is caused by the stars that are there. Stars' colors depend on their temperatures. The hotter a star is, the shorter the wavelengths it will emit. So a very hot star will give off lots of blue and violet and will appear very blue to our eyes. A cooler star would give off a very red color and look very red to our eyes. So the colors that we see tell us something about the temperatures of a star. So here we're seeing a lot of very hot stars, and very hot, very massive stars are stars that have recently formed. Now we know that they have formed recently because they have a very short lifespan, lasting only a few million years in many cases, and therefore they must have formed within the last few million years, or they would already be gone. So in terms of a galaxy that may be billions of years old, a few million years is a very short period of time. Now, as we compare this galaxy to others that we look at, we see that it is very distorted. And you notice the upper spiral arm is kind of pulled out from the rest of the galaxy, and it become distorted through galactic collisions. So galaxies collide together. And in fact, there is another galaxy known as ARP273, very close to this one, which would be causing this distortion. Galaxies, when they interact through gravity. The gravity pulls at the material and distorts the generally crisp, clean spirals that we typically see in a spiral galaxy, and distort them in this galaxy, sometimes pulling out various wisps of material and distorting the galaxy overall. And in addition, they cause additional star formation. So why do we see so many hot pockets of blue stars here? Would also be because of that gravitational interaction, which causes gas clouds to collide together and compress, enhancing the rate of star formation. So a galaxy like this would always be forming stars, but the interaction with another galaxy enhances that star formation rate. Now, what will likely happen over time is that the galaxies will eventually coalesce together into a single galaxy. And if we could come back in a billion years or so, we would likely see just an ordinary galaxy here, not showing any signs of this interaction. And it's kind of like throwing a rock into the pond. You can see the distortion in the waves that are created, but if you wait a minute, all of a sudden it's gone. Well, galaxies can do the same thing on a much longer time scale. When they combine together, they will eventually form a new galaxy. And after a long period of time, they will look just as though nothing had ever happened. So when we see galaxies interacting like this, we are just catching them at one of those stages when they happen to be interacting. But all galaxies, including our own Milky Way, have gone through stages like this in the past and will go through stages like it again in the future. So that was our picture of the day for October the 18th of 2020. It was titled UGC 1810 Wildly Interacting Galaxy from Hubble. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be spot on. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.